We end our report on Burma where it began, with UNU at the Schwedagon.
Do you think there is in the West any basis for a moral appeal or a moral fervor that can hold its own against the material appeal of communism?
I do not want you to underestimate the moral appeal as against the material appeal of any ism, you see, in the world. Because I'm quite confident that it will be the moral appeal that will ultimately triumph.
Does communism have a moral appeal, and if so, is it a genuine one?
I do not think, you see, the communism has any moral appeal, because I want to tell you some of the, experiences of my own. From 1948 to 1950, for 3 years, more than 9/10 of the country had been in the hands of the insurgents. The slogans of lands to the tillers, factories to the workers, and so on, caught the imagination of the people more easily than anything else we could possibly say to these people at that time. And so. Most of the people supported the insurgents. And at that time, we had no arms. And what was worse, we had no soldiers to fight the insurgents. But we kept on saying to the people this. Yes, you may get lands, and you may get factories, and you may even get all the things you want from the government stores under the insurgents. But, mind you, you will lose the fundamental freedoms which you must possess as a human being.
Did people learn that lesson, do you think?
After some time, they realized that what we told them was quite true. And since that time, quite a lot of people who had given support, shelter, and food, you see, to the insurgents, turned away from these people. And in certain cases, these people fought them with whatever arms they possessed. And now, you see, more than 9/10 of the country is in our hands. And I must tell you that our triumph over the insurgent is the triumph of the moral appeal over the material appeal.
You've often said that one of the worst things about the Burmese communists is that they take orders from their foreign masters. Well, presumably those foreign masters are in China and Russia, and yet when you go to Moscow or Beijing, everything is very friendly. We in the West don't quite understand this, sir.
Are we friendly only with the communists? Are we not friendly also with the anti-communists?
Yes.
Then why is it, you see, that this friendship, you see, with the communists should puzzle you in the West? Why?
Well, I think it puzzles us.
We are friendly with
everybody.
With everybody.
But not with the Burma Communist Party, which is outlawed.
Yes. It was outlawed because they were not communists. They were outlawed because they tried to overthrow the government by violent means. If they like to contest in the, elections and seize power through democratic means, they will be given, full freedom to come and contest in the elections.
I see. One of the characters in your play, The People Win Through, says that communism in China and communism in Burma are not at all the same thing. Could you explain that?
Yes. Communism in China means the raising of the standard of living of the people, whereas communism in Burma means taking orders from outside, as you told me just now.
Do you feel that the accomplishments of the Chinese Communist government match up or outweigh the loss of freedom that has taken place there?
I was not long enough in China, you see, to find out all these. But I must tell you that I gave a good deal of credit, you see, to what the Chinese leaders are doing for their own people. Yes, they are very much devoted to the welfare of the Chinese people.
Do you think the United States should recognize Communist China and that she should be admitted to the United Nations?
Yes. You may not believe in communism, you see. For instance, I don't believe in communism myself, but I recognize China.
Everyone with whom we've talked here in Rangoon indicates that Burma wants socialism permanently as a way of life. Now that you've visited the United States, Unu, do you still feel that American-style capitalism is not relevant to Burma's problems?
The conditions in the United States and in the countries in Asia are quite different. So if we introduce American-style capitalism into the countries in Asia, I think it will bring about undesirable economic discrepancies. The rich will become richer, very much richer, and the poor will become very much poorer. So in that case, it will bring about much discontent and dissatisfaction, you see, throughout Asia. Then I believe it will be a sure means of installing communists in Southeast Asia. So I do not want American-style capitalism to be introduced into Southeast Asia.
Sir, in a See It Now interview with you 3 years ago, Senator Margaret Chase Smith asked you if you had any criticisms to make of American policy. You were very polite, as I remember, but you said you thought American politicians talk too much. Do you still feel that way?
Yes. But I don't find fault seriously with the Americans for talking too much. In America, you know very well, you see, there is freedom of speech. So they enjoy it to the fullest extent. That is the reason. Yes.